Good morning, friends. I thought today, why don't we talk a little bit about this stuff we're dealing with? This COVID stuff we're dealing with right now is not by chance. It's the beginning of the most exciting transformation of your life so far. I love the way Joel Osteen says it's not a setback, but rather a set up for a comeback. What a great way to say opportunity. Wait, let me amend. Opportunities. But before we talk about those, let me share our trade system for getting to positive. He calls it STOP. He developed this years ago, and he says that S stands for stop. Right now, just stop, he says. T, take a deep breath, or maybe more. O, observe yourself. And P, proceed with joy. Boy, it helps to focus on what you can control, though, one step at a time. We tend to become so anxious because we worry and we overthink things that we can't even control. And you know what? They may not even happen in the future. So whenever that feeling creeps up, take action one step at a time on something that you can control, because that way you are indeed taking care of things as you can. So stop a minute, right where you are, right now. Relax your shoulders. Take a very deep breath through your nose. Engage that nitric oxide. You know it engages the rest and restore parasympathetic nervous system. And let it out. Tell that demanding voice in your head to be still and proceed with joy. Can somebody say opportunities? Let's talk about present opportunities right now. I have two colleagues, and I'm sure there are many more who I know of, who are so busy with emergencies in their office. They said they're so busy, it's amazing. Now, some of these patients they'll never see again because they are patients who only come for emergent care. And some of these patients may be new patients for the future, but the point is they're staying busy right now. And besides that, you can read, study, grow, family time. Think of the positive aspects to this time. And keep thinking of the positive aspects, right? Now let's talk about future opportunities. The sky is the limit. Some dental practices and businesses are going to fly. I mean, some folks are going to do great things. Decide you're one of those folks. Think creatively. You're going to create your own opportunities. If the worry and anxiety are really tough for you, again, try trace stop, S-T-O-P. Stop, take a deep breath or more, observe yourself, proceed with joy. That backs you away from the tough parts. I love Diamond and Silk the other day said, when you can do nothing about nothing, do nothing. That's actually the serenity prayer, right? Change what you can, accept what you can't change. And what can you change? Listen, right now you can follow the rules of the moment. Here they are. And let's just lay them out because this is an important concept for everyone. No matter where you are, these are important right now. Do not touch anyone except other well family members nowhere. Just don't do it. Don't do it. That's different from do it. This time, it's don't. Now, obviously, for those of you in practicing emergencies, I'm going to leave that aside because you know the protocols. Dentists are better than most people at actual aseptic techniques. But for all of us, we wash our hands now. Wash, wash, wash. 20 seconds with soap every time. And if you can't, you can disinfect if hand washing is not possible, but hand washing is the best. Next, wear gloves when you're out and about for groceries. And only touch the cart, the fridge doors, whatever you're touching in that store with a gloved hand, and the non-gloved hand can pick up your items. Peel the gloves off inside out. Don't leave, you know. For those of you who are dentists, you know that beyond a shadow of a doubt. But for all of you, peel them off inside out when you finish, before you get in your car, before you even get to your car. And guys, I'm so sad to see people throwing those gloves in the parking lot. Throw them away in a trash can. And if there's not one there, they're inside out. You can lay them down on the floor of your car and pick them up later because they're inside out. Now, next rule of this moment, Social distancing. You know the rule. It's so valuable because, remember, your touch is the vector transmission that's been shown to be the main method of transmission. And don't touch your face, no matter what, no matter what, no matter what. We've got to get used to that. It's not easy. All of us touch our face. One study I saw said 24 times a day. 24 times a day, was it? Or maybe more. It's unbelievable. So don't touch your face, whatever you do. Work at it. And finally, mask only if you're in a small place with people, because most of the time you can avoid being in small places. So the main thing is your gloves and not touching your face. Do you know that the vector getting into the eyes is the easiest way into your body, even easier than in your nose and mouth? And finally, remember the P, proceed with joy. Enjoy your day. Do the positive aspects. Focus on them. A joyful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. And that's a great proverb, 17:22. So skip on to your morning. It's a beautiful day. And again, another saying for you. I'm doing all these sayings today. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. There's never been a night that didn't turn into a morning. Here's the thing. If you try to do it, even though it may be impossible, it's as if God steps back. I love the way this is said. I think Joel Osteen said, and lets you work on it. Instead, trust God for the things you really can't do. You know, the infinite wisdom that gave us this perfect desire for this time to change in some ways will reveal to us the perfect plan. The same God that gave us the desire will reveal the perfect plan for the unfolding of your desire for it to be different. Know that your connection to the Almighty through your subconscious mind is now working. What you feel and claim will express in your world, in your without. What's within, you will express in the without. And your job, remember, is to let God handle it. Turn it over. He's got the whole world in his hands. Just please think about this. Some practices, some businesses, some folks are going to thrive after this setup for their comeback. Decide right now, you're one of them. Napoleon Hill said, the man who does more than he's paid for will soon be paid for more than he does. And I add, you know, in love, first and foremost. Don't forget, you miss every shot you don't make. Michael Jordan, give it your best shot. So y'all, as the astoundingly wonderful Diamond and Silk said, y'all, we're gonna be all right. Again, this stuff we're dealing with right now, it's not by chance. It's the beginning of the most exciting transformation of your life so far. I say boom and love.